I've got video. There we go.
Don't forget to record today.
Yeah, I turned on the recording.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, that was a little painful the other day.
Oh, good thing I didn't have to look back on anything.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I space that one.
So, I thought I saw it recording, but I guess I was hallucinating.
Yeah, I could have sworn that I turned it on, so yeah, didn't. I was very debating to just turn right around and re-record it without you there just to have it, but I decided that would have to wait.
Yeah, it was pretty late at night.
All right. All right, so week number three. I look to see if you've done the discussion yet this week.
I have.
Okay, I'll look at that. What I'd like to also do is look at your week, your assignment from last week. Mm-hmm. So, what I'll do is I'll share my screen here. Review that. Always the Zoom thing just kind of, let's share the screen there.
Yeah, a little slow today.
All right, can you see on my screen your project?
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right, so here we're just doing the 2D creation, character creation. Background and so on from last week. And so when you went and designed this, did you find this? It's this background?
Yeah, I went surfing and I found it.
Background with road. Yeah, very... very appropriate. I don't know what you searched to find it, but I thought that was very appropriate.
Yeah, it just took me a while. I usually type in cartoon images or whatever, and that's what I sometimes get.
Okay. Yep, and that looks familiar.
Yeah, a little putt-putt.
That looks familiar. And we have the Turtle Wax Cleaner itself.
Yeah, there's two different ones. I hadn't decided which one I was going to use. But I also, I realized this morning that I forgot to put in the swampy mud stuff, so I put in a swamp, a picture of a swamp. I imported it into the library, and then, I found some sound clips that I wanted to use.
Oh, okay, good.
And I exported those onto, or imported those onto the, into the library.
Well, that's perfect. Okay, good. And there's a little bit of a two-dimensional aspect to the bushes here. We have things in the foreground and things kind of in the background and the path through here. So what are you currently planning on doing with the turtles as far as taking into consideration that this image is two-dimensional or three-dimensional?
I was going to, yeah, the turtles are going to come from left on the road. And then they're going to walk, and then they're going to walk right in front of the bushes.
Oh, okay.
And they're going to have their little talk.
Okay.
There. And then just to the bottom right, I'm going to put in that mud puddle. It's going to appear. And then, and of course, the car's going on the road.
Yeah. Yeah, I see. It's going to walk in front, right in here.
Yeah.
And are you going to have the car present in the first few scenes? Or how does that just, the car is going to be going on this road here?
Yeah, it's going to be going on that road. I think what I'm going to do is slowly introduce the back end of the car, like they're going to be walking over to it. Mm-hmm. So as they get closer to the car will be moving right to left until they meet up with the car. And then it'll at the end, the turtles will get in the car and drive off.
Okay. Now, this image is all one image right now. And in order to animate, I'm not sure if you were planning on animating the tires turning or just animating the car going from left to right. What was your thought there?
I'm torn. It might be easier just to do the car idling.
Right.
Because I found a clip that it just has the car like idling. And then I can get them. I was thinking of having the wheels move enough to where it looks like they're gonna speed off. And the muffler smoke is also separate, so I can tweak the muffler smoke.
Okay.
So it looks like it's actually,
emitting smoke.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, this area you can cut that away and
then... Yeah, I left it so I did it so I could detach it and move it away and make it look like it's smoking.
And this was an AI. Were these in separate layers or in your Adobe Illustrator file?
Yeah, they're all separate.
Oh, okay.
I grouped them together to get them imported. But if I looked at the library and they're all individual pieces.
Yeah. Now that is in Adobe Illustrator, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. They've been imported in now and now they're just one piece. When you did the import, I think you told it to put all layers on a single layer.
Oh.
So
then I can just break that apart. I could still break them apart though. I'll just break them apart in Illustrator and import just the pieces.
Yeah. In fact, you could retry your import, and this time when you import, it would give you an option on breaking it apart and keeping them on separate layers. But you're right, you can also do what you're suggesting, which is to delete and or redo it, just the parts, and then cut them out of here. So you'll eventually have a car that's made up of other movie clips that are, because right now, look at that, it is these, oh, I thought I was going to be able to select just the
wheels.
Yeah. Interesting. The wheels themselves are. So yeah, you can play around with this. You can actually do it in here. You don't have to re-export it. You can select all and copy and then create like a new layer, and then on that layer you can do paste the object, and that way you can edit it as it is, because right now it's all in a single layer, and if you delete these and put them in their own on their own layer, in their own object, then you can animate those.
Okay.
So what we can do is we can actually work on this and get that animated and get it broken apart, and various layers here, make it so that you can still select these and cut them out and just paste them into different layers, and then we can animate those, and so we can go from there. So the cleaner itself, that's for like an advertisement at the end.
Yeah, it's for, like, you know, the end product of what it is. Or I was thinking it could be the play button at the beginning.
Okay. That's an interesting idea. Mm-hmm. To do that like that.
Yeah, I was going to make it I was really thinking of making it the play button.
All right.
Because I still have the codes on how to do a play button, so I was just going to switch up the image from an Angry Bird play picture to the turtle wax picture.
Gotcha. Yeah, that would be interesting to have your turtle wax playable at the beginning. Click that to go.
Yeah.
All right. So this week, I think I heard you say you got some sound effects.
Yeah.
So and the animation we'll be working on, and you can create a path for your animation to follow the turtles to follow on that path, like you were saying.
Yeah.
So and I think your plan is to gotta stop my video. I think your plan is to Flip the one turtle.
Yeah. So, and I'm gonna change that. The turtle that flips, he's gonna be a slightly different color.
Okay.
So that you can tell the difference between turtles.
Okay. Now, one thing you can do is to animate their movement and their size too. So they can begin in small, here, and then they follow this path, and they get big. They get bigger, and by the time they're here, wherever they stand, they've kind of grown in size because they appear closer.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure how big you want these turtles to be relative to your background. So that's one thing you can do, starting back here, getting larger. We talked about animating the turtle and its legs, cutting those up and then having them move back and forth. That's probably not necessary. I think I heard you say, well, what is your plan for them moving?
I did also break the legs apart so that they move, and I also broke the mouth apart so it moves.
Oh, okay.
And I might have imported it wrong again.
Yeah, they're all on the same layer.
Okay. Yeah, I even I'll have to fix that because the legs are separate and the mouth is separate and the eyes are separate too. Or supposed to be separate. Let me rephrase that.
Yeah, they are definitely selectable. Let's see here. I'm trying to select just the one there. See that? Yeah, so they are set up for that. The mouth is going to be a little bit of a...
Yeah, I might need to edit that.
So that allows you to... you could put the turtle... We animate the turtle, and the turtle shell can be on the top layer and the legs on the bottom layers. And when they move back and forth, and the legs appear to be underneath the shell.
So the shell will need to move also.
Yeah.
Okay.
It'll be just like the car. You have a symbol that represents the entire turtle, and we'll animate it so the legs are moving. That will be part of that symbol. It'll be a movie clip that has one layer for each leg. Let's see, that's going to be a hinged effect rather than a rotation.
We
have a point of reference rather than the center. It could be, for example, up here, up right, and so that everything can rotate relative to that reference point. When you create a symbol, you have that ability to specify. Oops, I keep doing that. You have the ability to specify the registration point and upper left, upper right. So when you convert these to two symbols, you'll want, depending on their hinging, where you want the hinging to take place, that will determine upper right corner. For example, would make it hinge around the upper right corner of the object, center top, would allow it to pivot on that axis, upper left hinge, and that would pivot on that axis. So when you're creating the symbol, that's how that works. Okay, so let's see. So we work on animation, and then also soundtrack. So 24 times, let's see, 24 times 30 is 720 frames. Okay. So what I'd like to do is have you share the screen. I'll let you share the screen. And what I'd like to do is start to design the next step on this animation with you on your timeline. And I'll coach you along the way. So is that okay?
Yeah, that's cool. Just give me 1 second. Yeah, there's the swamp I forgot to put in. Oh, and so forth. I should tear apart the turtle first, right?
Yeah, let's think about that. Are you have you shared your screen?
Yeah.
Let me see.
I think it's just taking a bit.
Oh yeah. Okay. I can see. That's perfect.
It's the car. My computer's running a little.
What time did you say you had to go today?
My son has an appointment at, I have to leave, by about 2.
Sure.
Yeah, last night, was a rough night. I went to the, robotics meeting without him because he hadn't been doing his homework. And I asked him, when I got back, I'm like, are you done? He said, yes. So I'm like, well, let me see it. And he all of a sudden couldn't find it. So then it was, well, where is it? And I told him for every missing assignment, he owes me 10 push-ups.
Wow.
And and so it made me upset. So I told him for lying now, you owe me 20 per missing page. So he got done, and he owed me, by the time he got done, he had to do 120 push-ups.
Oh, my.
And so, yeah, I wasn't too thrilled with him last night.
Huh. Push-ups, eh? Well, he'll develop some pretty strong muscles.
Yes, he will. Well, the fact of the matter is to get him to learn that there's consequences to his actions. And it wouldn't have been, but it would have been upset if he, you know, told it, if he would have told the truth, I still would have been a little bit upset, but not as upset as I was. And so I told him, you know, basically, if you would have just told the truth, I wouldn't have been as upset, and you wouldn't have had to do half of those push-ups.
Mm.
So trying to teach them, you know, every action has a reaction.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so we should be, that's independent.
You thinking a wagon and tail?
I might. I just threw it in there. As independent as a just in case.
Yeah.
Because I was just thinking, you know, just to make sure I covered all my bases.
I gotcha.
So import to library. Turtle. Might help if I save it. Okay, so to make them on individual, I would just, this says just on layer one, so I would just uncheck the these two boxes, right?
Yeah.
Okay, now they're all individual?
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to. When you do check those, it checks everything. It's going to put them all. So what might be better is if you just the ones that you want separate. Let's see, convert layers.
Oh, I see what you're saying. So the ones that I want separate are like the legs.
Right.
That's a leg. That's a leg. Okay. So his legs didn't come with him.
Yeah, so we got to animate that guy. Let's see. When you did the import, did you deselect the legs?
Yeah. Was I not supposed to?
Well, let's see. We'll have to import. Let's see, we deselect the legs. That means you're telling AI we don't want to bring those in.
Oh. So then let me import his legs then.
Yeah. One thing you could do is import it, and we can do this right in Flash.
I just decided to import everything. Yeah. And don't you hold down shift to make it smaller?
Yeah, the transpose, you have the tool upper right, far way over the, in your tools menu, way over there.
Right there.
Yeah. And you can hold the shift key down and it scales it. Thank you. Okay, so
I was just gonna adjust his color.
Okay.
Stop it. Oops.
Were you planning on making it black?
The oops was as I did the wrong green. Hey. No. Romeo, no. That's not the same green, is it? Romeo? Don't start. All right.
Okay.
That leg. Thank you. folks. I was gonna flip. Flip him.
Flip 180.
So yeah, and it flipped him over.
Upside down.
I don't want to do that. So if I did 180.
Let's see times. It's a 24.
I'm going the wrong way. Alright, I got a solution to that. Okay, so actually,
the moment of truth.
Dun, dun, dun.
There you go.
I solved that problem.
Yeah, let's see. You could have them following each other. That's fine.
Like that?
Yeah, I mean, let's see.
Because then the path will be, the path for them will be that they're going to walk this way. Yeah, they're going to walk this way. And then this guy's going to flip around.
Yeah, turning around, that's, when you have a 2D image, it's kind of like you can't lift him off the stage. He's in 2D, he's not in 3D. And what you were trying to do is, like, let's see, flip left to right, let's see.
Or we can do it this way. Yeah, we can do it this way. Okay. You go away for a second. You come here. So then now I think to solve that issue, he'll just stay here. Maybe I'll have his tail just, you know, wagging and his eyes moving around. Like he's just, you know, standing there in boredom. And then this guy is going to come up to him.
That's a great idea. I like that.
Yeah, I think that'll work a little bit better.
Yeah, you did a very good job with that.
Okay. And then, and then as he gets closer, He'll get bigger.
Yeah, good.
Let's see. Yeah, I think that'll work. So what I would need to do then is, he can stay on the first layer, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and then I'm going to need to put him on a different layer, correct?
Okay. Command V, bring it back. You can just do a Command Z. Back. Click on this. Yeah. You probably already know this. Okay.
But he's on the first layer. Shouldn't he not be? He shouldn't be on that layer, right?
Well,
because I've got to animate him to come closer.
Right. And we have to animate his legs, and then we have to animate his whole body. The whole body can take place up in the main stage, scene one. while the leg animations can happen within the object itself, and because it's if you convert it to a simple make a movie clip, then you'll be able to house that. So
okay, so let's say since oops. You know what? Yeah, I just got tired of clicking on the background and it moving on me. I eventually learned my lesson after a few times of doing it.
Okay, it's still pretty quick.
No, you're too big. There you go there. Okay, I guess what I'm running into is like, okay, so let's say this guy right here, let's say I have him doing his movements for, what, 10 frames, and then I can have him do his for the next
15 frames.
15 frames.
Or maybe 20.
And they're on the, yeah, I like to do an even 20 on that. But they both can be on the same, frame that way.
Yeah, I mean, they'll, if they're both being animated, they'll be on their own separate layer.
Well, so then he needs to be on one layer, and then he needs to be on a layer.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're both going to be animated. It'll be the whole turtle that's animated. So you double-click on the symbol itself and make sure that effect is pointing to one of the proper...
The proper turtle. So then... Okay, so then this one would
which I
lost what I was gonna do.
If you double click on that, you convert it to a symbol. Yeah, but let's see, because these legs are going to be animated. The turtle needs to be edited. And let's see, in that timeline, the symbol itself, the turtle symbol itself, will have its own timeline. That's where we can do the animations of just the turtle of walking.
So this, not this guy. This guy is the guy that we would want to modify.
Yeah.
You can convert to symbol.
Convert to a symbol.
And I'm going to put... Don't. Okay, so then now that I've converted that to a symbol,
now we can edit it and create an animation. So, see, was the whole thing grouped when you did that convert to symbol?
I didn't know I grouped everything.
It does say it's grouped. Okay. So here you got your timeline. So right now you're looking at scene one, but if you double click on that.
Double click on. It grouped it up again.
All right, so let's see. Okay, so.
Nah.
So really what we want to do is create layers here. It looks like we have groups of groups, so we'll want to have the legs each on their own layers. Can I mute for just a second?
Sure.
Okay, be right back. Thank you, I'm back.
Okay.
So we're gonna animate here each leg. And let's see. That, can we create other layers? We're gonna have one layer for each, I'm gonna try to have one layer for each leg. And so we'll have a primary layer where we have the shell and the head, neck, mouth, and then each of those layers will remove the leg from that primary, each of the legs from that primary layer, and we'll just introduce the legs, each leg on its own layer, and so that it's not all on just one layer. You can even rename the layers to
leg one, leg two.
Yeah.
Okay. So the one that's highlighted now would be the front right leg.
Yeah.
So this is the one that would be doing its first motion, right? We would be making this move, correct?
Yeah, and it would pivot on the upper left corner, from the upper left corner, and
so then
right now all of your object is on the front right layer. See the black dot on frame one? Look down here. Look down at the timeline. See that black dot? All that means that only this layer has something on it.
Okay, so it's just this leg.
Well, frankly, it's the entire drawing. Wait a minute. I'm studying. Look above your stage, and it says like group, and then turtle one, and all that. So let's get clear on all that because each of these are. Let's study that really clearly. Here's the architecture of this animation. We really want to have out here in scene one, this is going to be dealing with one movie clip, but when we go into that movie clip, it will be doing, we'll have one layer. So when we go into that symbol, that movie clip from this layer, it will be the turtle, and we'd have those five layers. So right now, I think we might not have it exactly architected just right. So double click on the left turtle. Again, let me do the first double click and let's study what we got. Okay, so do that one more. Yeah, okay. So this movie clip, yeah. So we're going to have to duplicate the turtle across each of the layers, but we delete out what we don't want on each.
Oh, okay. So then if I think I got it. I mean like so if I was to move this leg up. And then hang on. So if I do this.
We want to duplicate the whole. See, one way of doing this is you select the whole thing. And you duplicate it across, and you copy. You click on the layer, and you paste it. Click on the next layer, paste it. Click on the next layer, paste it. And then we go back and we delete what we don't want on that layer. So it's kind of like
I know we want to do the get the flipbook.
Yeah.
So, the flipbook thing, but I guess I'm just trying to figure out.
One thing you could do is copy that and then go to another layer and then cut it from this layer, go to another layer and paste it, because we're going to have an animation on each layer.
Okay, let me do this then. Okay, so then I'm gonna click on this.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna copy it, correct?
Excuse me.
Bless you.
Pardon me. Bless you. Yeah, we're already on the front right layer.
Yeah. So, okay, so then I'm going to go to the front.
See, the front right leg is already there. So if we can select everything except the front right layer. See, there you can cut that. Go ahead and cut that from this layer. And now click on front left layer, and then turn off with your eye, turn off the front right, turn off front right. That's what I was kind of expecting the whole body to go away when you turned off the view on the front right.
Yeah.
See,
that was the whole.
That's what I expected right there. Now go to click on the front left layer. Click there, now paste.
Paste right here. Where'd it go? It won't.
Yeah, in fact, you need to go ahead and select the frame itself, frame one on the front left, right there. Now, see if you paste. So what we're pasting is the object. So let's do that again. The goal here is to cut the leg and then paste to the next layer.
Okay, so we'll go.
Okay, I need to mute for 1 second.
All right.
Be right back.
Okay. Thank you.
stand back.
Okay.
So how when you turn off when you turn off front right, what gets turned off? Is that working? See, we gotta get to the point where that
goes away.
Yeah. We turn off front right and it's front, it's that leg, you don't see it. Yeah, that's the goal here.
Well, and I don't know why it won't go away.
It suggests that there are more things. Did that one work? Or no? Or
I took this. I copied it. No, I cut it.
Yeah, that's right.
I cut it. And then
That's what I'm expecting, is that you should be able to paste the object that you cut.
Hang on. I'll put that back. Take this. Do that. Copy frames. Put that there.
Okay. I was thinking the same thing that you were thinking. I'm wondering if it has something to do with the grouping, but keep going. Let's select. Let's see.
I even thought of doing.
So that's the movie clip. It might be, look at the level we're at up in the, above the stage, it says Turtle One. The movie clip is at that level, but if you go to the left, you have an object there, Turtle AI. See, what concerns me is that is also everything. And so we're down deeper trying to have just pieces of this thing, and yet it seems like the object above us is everything already there. So
then
it's like preventing us from being able to surgically work on the individual parts, because the level above us, if it is everything, then okay, so that right there at that level, see, this should work for us right here at this level.
Okay, so shall I? Oh, let's see. Cut this. And then where am I putting it? Here?
Yeah. And it's not the frame that we're pacing per se. It's the object on the frame that we're trying to paste. Let's see.
Let's do this. No, I lied. I didn't want to do that. All right. So
Damn it, I did it again.
Okay, so I've got it selected. So now if I cut it, right, and then I'm going to put it on the front left level?
Yeah, I mean, sometimes you can select the whole thing and then paste it at each level and then just cut out the portion that you don't want. Or you can do the way you're doing it. You can cut that one piece off of one level, go to the next level, paste it, and it'll paste right in the same place. But it seems like the paste becomes paste frames when you have selected that.
Yeah.
I know it's something to leave. It's
yeah.
So let's do this. Why don't you... I think I've got the same thing to work with. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to work with this myself and see if I, because you know, watching you do it, it seems like you're doing it the way I would do it. So what I'm going to do is I can work on seeing what I'm not getting about how it's structured and imported from Adobe Illustrator.
Yeah.
See if I can sort it out.
Okay, but I'm going on the right track, right? I mean, yeah. I logically get it. It's in my brain, but
yeah, I'm right where you are. It's just it looks like you're doing the right keystroke. So that's okay. That's why I want to try to see if I can do it myself, so I can understand what's really going on.
What's going on? All right. Yeah, I should be back. Probably by about four-ish.
Okay.
Yeah.
Why don't you just ping me when you're back and,
okay. I can do that.
Okay.
All right. Sweet. Thanks. I'll text you when I'm ready.
All right. Perfect.
All right. Thanks. Bye.
All right, bye. Oh, whoops.
Forgot. Hey, looking for a new car, are you? On Craigslist, huh?
Yes.
Where's that one going to lead you?
Actually, I'm selling it, if you want. Oh. I'll do an ad here.
it doesn't have any real animation.
Yeah. Let me see. What can I do about that?
Hey, you're financing too. All right.
Yeah. Not in America. Yep. So, make me an offer.
Well, I like the 400 part. No.
Yeah, one payment.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, well, let's do this. Why don't you you said you made some progress, so
share desktop, share. That's as far as I went. Excuse me.
All right, do it one more time.
Okay.
Okay. All right, so we got scene one. We got a... animation with scene one there.
You're just like,
what layer is that turtle on?
Layer 5.
Okay.
So it's nowhere near, it's after It's after layer three, which is the I should just name that. That is the wax can.
It's like a flying saucer.
Yeah. I thought it was smooth enough right on in there and then up. So, and then this is background. Okay. So then this will be lift face Kurt. Okay, so so I got this guy on here, and I was just starting to fiddle with the legs.
Okay.
And so I went ahead and so he's not there. He enters here because that's when they'll push play. And so, I forgot to see where the other one was. So we're at 36, 37. Oops. We're here. Okay, here we go. Is it in the conference or is it in the next one? Okay. So then if we move that leg. That leg. So then that should at least get no. See, that's where I run into. I just individually moved the legs and everything, but it didn't add the motions.
Okay. So the we have to build a moving turtle with motion built into it. And so when you double click him, when you double click, do you go into him as a symbol?
Yeah. Oh, cause
go ahead and let me have you. Well, it's interesting because the I'm looking at the layer with the tweening layer.
Yeah, and it says motion right there, right?
Yeah, that's
okay.
Right. So why don't you go ahead and double click on him once again?
Okay.
Okay, so we are now into him, and okay. So over the upper right, can you click on properties?
Yeah.
Okay. because it thinks that we are selected on a HTML5 canvas document as opposed to the turtle himself. Can you turn off on that layer with the eye, turn off that layer. Let me see if he goes away. Yeah, he does.
Okay. Yeah, so he disappears.
Good sign. Okay. That he's definitely on that layer. And so it's really here that we're wanting to create an animation of just him moving to the background. You can see in scene one, it's kind of grayed out just because that's there, but it's
not. We're not working on it or anything. I was just looking to see if I added bones, but it won't let me.
Yeah, it's a function of what you've got selected. So, so why don't you use your select tool, upper right, and then select him.
And all of him or just the leg?
Well, you can try just the leg and see if the bone tool now becomes an option. Okay, so then, still thinks it's a grouped object. Okay.
So then that way, if we do this and then break apart.
Yeah, it'll definitely break that apart with lots of, go ahead and try it and let's see what it is thinking. Okay.
Well, it's doing something because it changed the. That's different now.
Yeah, I guess the outline. Yeah. See, stroke and fill. That if it's a stroke and fill, it doesn't think like it's an object yet. That particular thing itself, the leg itself, also needs to be on its own layer, and it needs to be a symbol also.
Okay, so what if I, let me put this
a movie clip
back.
Transpose, you can use the transpose if that's a trans.
Oh, here, I'll just do this.
Back of that.
There it is. Okay. So then.
Well, just like with the other one, we want to have each of the legs be symbols on their own layer.
Okay, so then I'll put two. Okay, so. Layer two is, okay, this is layer one. That's left, front, right. Is back left. Tail. Okay. So we're going to go to left front. And then we're going to convert this to a symbol. G1LF. Okay, so then this right here, so I just converted that to a symbol. It's by itself, it's on its own layer. So then this is where I would insert a frame. I think I'm going to have to rework the legs.
I think it stopped sharing your screen.
Hang on real quick. Where'd it go? Oops. There you are. I think these legs.
The stroke and fill need to be selected, I guess, before you make the symbol.
Yeah, so if in here, let me go back. Okay. That goes here. This goes here. Why isn't it? Okay. There.
Okay, so in its present state.
Sorry, the background. I forgot to lock the background again. Why won't it? Because I'm being a goober. Okay, so in its present state, it's technically all together, correct?
It's a group of, quote unquote, it's a group of objects right now. Each of those areas, when you do, you know, select all, you can see all those little objects that's made up of... When you do the break apart, you can see them, for example. So right there, this is where we don't want to convert this itself to the symbol.
So then I would want to go double click, and this is where I would. Should I break it apart now and then do each layer?
Yeah, at this level, this is where we need the granularity of the different legs. And
okay, so then what I would do here then is
Each leg is going to be its own symbol.
Okay, so then this is... Lift, front, that one is oops. Okay, so then I'm going to go to the left front. Okay, so now I'm on the left front, and it's marked left front, the layer. So then I'm going to, this is where I would convert to symbol, correct? Yes,
right.
Okay, all right. So then I'll convert all of these to their own little symbols.
Right.
Okay, so let me do that. Thank you.
Make it quick. No fooling around. Okay, so now the tail and all four legs are now on their separate layers, and they're all converted to a symbol.
Yeah, so let's look at the right front again. So if you turn off all the other layers, it should just have a right front left over. All right, what that means is everything's on that one layer.
That sucks. I just went through.
Looks like the tail is...
is this layer right here.
Yeah, go ahead and hide that layer. Let's see what happens.
It all transferred back down to this layer.
So it's on the...
it's all on the first layer again.
So you have them selected and they have converted to symbols, but they're all symbols on that one layer. So this time, let's go ahead and select the right front and then go ahead and in your drawing, I think you made its own.
There. But it just went back down to left.
Okay, let's see, go back and select it again. Is it selected?
Yeah.
And now cut it. Go back. Yeah, and now just if you can cut.
And then go here and paste.
Yeah.
Sure.
No, it's not the layer that we're pasting, it's just the object we just cut. Click on properties up the upper right. Let's see what it thinks you're selected on. Not that kind.
Not that one.
Right there. Okay, right now it thinks you've got a frame selected. So, which you do down there in your timeline. So, hide the turtle. And now click the stage. Now click properties upper right. Okay, so now do a command V. Open that, it'll paste the leg. Oops, wait a minute.
Oops.
We're selecting on something else. Let's click again.
Oh, here it is right here.
Uh-huh. Okay, that's good, but I'd like to back up a couple steps, undo it.
Okay.
And one more. And now do a click on properties. Let's see what it thinks you've got selected. Okay, good, that's what we want. Now do just a command V right now. Let's see if it drops. Just do it without clicking this canvas. I want it to, because the second time we click it, we kind of give it a location to paste it. And the first time we clicked it, we click it to select it. The second time we click it, it says put it here. And I really only want to select it. And when we paste it, it retains the attributes of its position and size. So it pasted it. But now you didn't select that right there. I mean, is that
paste? No, it automatically just put it right there.
Okay. All right. What is happening? All right. We'll turn the turtle back on that layer.
Okay.
Good news is we got a leg.
We got a leg up on ish. Let's see, turtle back on.
And now drag that down to where you want it. Okay, that's good. Oops. Okay, now so, do that again.
So go ahead and do the rest of the stuff like that?
Exactly.
Okay, so then we're going to go... left back, cut.
You can just do Control X.
And then Control V.
Well, you gotta select the next layer. I mean, the layer you want it on.
Left back.
Let's try Control V right now. I'm just curious. Yeah, okay.
That's kind of awkward, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out. It's supposed to land it back.
Where you took it from?
Retain all the location. So, but we're making progress. Cutting legs off. Fake legs.
Poor turtle never saw it coming.
Yeah. But the good news is we restore it right away.
Yeah. A little amputee turtle.
Yeah, we're going to have it join the Paralympics of turtle Paralympics. You're going to have a wagging tail.
Yeah, I got to have a wagging tail. There's that. And then I don't think I did this guy. All right, so we got all of the legs and the tail.
Okay, good. Do you want to do anything with the mouth?
We can. Let's see here. Let's do... lower... There you go. So we'll have legs, the lower jaw, and the tail.
Cool.
And so then, okay, so this technically then this layer and this turtle is set for me to start moving it and all that fun stuff, right?
Right. It's.
So then can I put in the other turtle now or?
It's going to do, you're going to have the same type of thing, but on its own.
On its different, its own little section, right?
Right. And this,
so then I would do this. And then. Then I would do this. No. This. That. Then I'm gonna do this. Oops, no. Then I'm gonna do this. Then I'm gonna do this. Okay, so then we're gonna do front. Um, and front. RF back. Oh, don't freeze on me now. We were just on a roll. Facing back, back, tail, so since we're okay, so, no, he's there. Convert to symbol. Cut. Now, why did you do that? Convert to symbol. Or draw. Okay. Okay. So if we do control Well, now, wait a minute. Yeah. Left back.
I figured out why I was having issues. You know how it was pasting it up in yonder?
Yeah.
Instead of pasting where it was supposed to be?
Right.
Because when I, let's say I cut this. Okay, and then paste in place.
Oh, there we go.
Okay. So let's see.
That's good.
This is cut. So we got all those tail. Cut, tail, paste in place. Cut, lower jaw, paste in place. Okay, so all of these guys are accounted for.
Say that one more time.
So all of these are all counted for.
Yeah, good.
Perfect. Okay. So, okay, so then we've got, this is T1. This is T2. Control. Oops. There. All right. So I got my fracking turtles. So then at this juncture, both the turtles are ready for, I've converted them, I converted to symbols, and they're all on their individual layers, so then I can go ahead and add the movements in to the turtles now.
That's right, on their, within
their different layers.
Yeah, I mean, you just now go in. And now we go into that turtle, and then we create the tween as though it were all by itself. And we create its movement and so on. And then when we take that moving movie clip, then when we bring it into the bigger scene, it will do what it's taught to do within its own movie clip. That makes
sense. So then I just wanted to do the steps for the second turtle while it was still fresh in my brain.
Yeah, very good. And so now you can create the tween, the pivots of the legs, whatever you want to do there. And if you want, it's 8 o'clock, so let's call it a night tonight.
Okay. But
if you want to meet tomorrow, we can resume. So
yeah, we can meet tomorrow. What time is good for you?
I'm thinking, let's see, maybe possibly noon. Let's target noon.
Target noon. Okay. Yeah. Cause yeah. That'll give me a couple of hours to, put in the movements and have something to show you that I've worked on.
Perfect.
For tomorrow. And we'll just go from there. I should be done by, with the animation itself. I should be done tomorrow.
So. Yeah. And so it's when you go in, you work on the animation of the individual turtles, it'll look like they're not moving anywhere. But their legs will move. And, you can do a forward, 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 backward, whatever. And it'll look like it's not moving anywhere. Because you can make it so that it just wiggles its legs in place. And then when you take that animation that wiggles its legs in place and we bring it out to this larger scene, and then on this scale, we create a tween out of the whole turtle going from left to right, or the little turtle going from out there in the distance, coming closer, getting bigger, and this tween will move. He'll move, and while he's moving, his legs will go flap, 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 flap. Because the tween itself, the turtle does, that's what the turtle does. And then it'll come forward. So, anyways, let's meet tomorrow. How's that?
That's awesome. Yeah. Noon it is. And right. If we run into anything, we just keep the lines of communication open.
Sounds good.
All right. Awesome. You have a great night.
Thanks. You too.
Thanks.
Okay. Bye.